Dear all, this video discusses about antennas. In any communication system, when you want to transmit information, basically you will have a transmitter which will be connected to an antenna. So the transmitter will be connected to an antenna, and along a distance you want to transmit the information, and at the receiving end again the information will be received, the signals will be received by another antenna, and this will be connected to the receiver. So any communication system, when you consider, in order to transmit the information from one place to another where you want to transmit without in a wireless manner, so we require antennas. So knowledge of antennas is very important when you want to design any communication system. So basically an antenna can be considered like this. So here you have a generator which will be generating the electromagnetic signals. So this transmitter is connected to a transmission line. This generator is connected to a transmission line. So this transmission line, if it is flared out like this, so this will act as an antenna. So when this is the generator, so this will generate a plane wave across this region. So this will generate a plane wave across this region. So as this is flared out, this wave will be spherically expanding wave. The wave becomes spherically expanding wave. So here the mode of propagation is TEM, because this is a transmission line. And this area where this is the transition region, the wave is changing from plane wave to a spherically expanding wave. This region is like a transition region or the antenna. So basically a radio antenna, it is defined as the structure associated with region of transition between a guided wave and a free space wave, or vice versa. So that depends upon whether the antenna is a transmitting antenna or a receiving antenna. So basically here this transmission line that is used for guiding the radio frequency waves from one point to another. So here this wave will be a plane wave, while as it moves to this region, this becomes spherically expanding wave. So here energy is guided as a plane wave with little loss, because the spacing between these two lines will be very small. But at the right, as the transmission line approaches, separation approaches a wavelength or more, so the wave tends to radiate outward. So it becomes opened out and it will be spherically expanding. So this area acts like an antenna. So antenna can also be defined as a transducer which converts a guided wave to a free space wave, or a free space wave to a guided wave. Now basically you have the basic antenna parameters. So antenna appears from the transmission line as a two terminal circuit. So here this is a two terminal circuit. So this is a generator. So consider a simple antenna, that is a dipole antenna. So that is formed by, now this is a transmission line. If you flare it out into the both sides, this acts like a dipole antenna. So basically the main parameters that has to be considered is, one is radiation resistance, which is denoted by RR. Then you have the radiation pattern, which is the how the pattern or how the wave antenna radiates. So how you can represent the electric and fields. So that is gives you field pattern and the power pattern. Then you have antenna temperature, which is represented as TA. Now here first one is radiation resistance. So radiation resistance as such, if you consider, that is the resistance coupled from the antenna and its environment to the antenna terminals. Not as such the resistance of the antenna, but it is the resistance coupled from the antenna and its environment to the antenna terminals. Then antenna temperature. Again, temperature is not as such the temperature of the antenna, but it is the It is the temperature of distant regions that is coupled to the antenna, so via its radiation resistance. So basically, this is a parameter that depends again on the temperature of the regions of the antenna. It is not like the temperature of the antenna, but this temperature, antenna temperature, is depending upon the temperature of the regions of the antenna. So both of this RR and TA are single valued scalar quantities. Now radiation pattern, basically that involve the variation of field or power as a function of two spherical coordinates theta and phi. So basically, when you consider an antenna in the spherical coordinate system, suppose you have placed the antenna over here and you have placed it in the spherical coordinate system. So how this field pattern and power pattern basically gives you how the antenna radiates or how the field distribution is of the antenna. So suppose you consider here you have placed the antenna. So this is how the antenna radiates. So this is the pattern, field pattern. So you have the maximum field in this direction and you have small fields or lobes. The small fields what you have is known as lobes, which is called as side lobes. And the major area where you have the maximum field pattern is known as the main lobe. And below the area where you have small lobes, those are known as back lobes. So basically, lobe means the field distribution basically, and depending upon where you have maximum and minima fields, that is named as main lobe and side lobes. So this is basically the field pattern. Similarly, you have the power pattern. So power pattern is also very similar. So this is how the power pattern will be. So you have maximum in this region and small lobes in the back directions. So wherever you don't have any field or power are known as nulls. So here there is an important parameter known as half power beamwidth. So half power beamwidth is obtained by drawing a line through the 3 dB or at the point where there is half power. So this will give you the half power beamwidth. So this angle gives the half power beamwidth. And next parameter, so this is obtained by equating the field E of theta equal to 1 by root 2. If you equate the given field equal to 1 by root 2 and find out the angle, that will give you the half power beamwidth. Then you have beamwidth between first nulls. So first null means that is the region. Null means it is the region where there is no field or power distribution. So here if you consider, this is the region where there is no null. So this will be the first null, because here you have the main lobe and here you have the side lobe. So first null, just after this main lobe, wherever you are getting the null, that is the first null. So finding out this angle, this will give you beamwidth between first nulls. So this is obtained by equating the field pattern equal to zero. So similarly, the field can also be shown in rectangular coordinate system. So if you expand the main lobe and side lobes, this is how you obtain it. So wherever you have 3 dB, that will give you the half power beamwidth. So also wherever you don't have any radiation pattern, that will give you the nulls. So this is how the field and power pattern of an antenna looks like. Now there are basically three patterns when you consider any antenna's pattern. So first one is the theta component of the electric field. So this as a function of theta and phi, or else this can be written as E theta of theta phi volt per meter. Similarly, you have the phi component of the electric field as a function of the angles theta and phi, or E theta theta phi in volt per meter. And also the phases of the fields as a function of angles theta and phi, which we denoted as delta theta or delta phi. Again, it is denoted by its unit is radians or degree, because basically it's the phase. Now here the normalized pattern. So normalized pattern usually we obtain by dividing the pattern by the maximum field. So normalized field pattern can be written as the given field divided by the maximum field. So we denote by N here, which denotes normalized pattern. So power per unit area. So usually patterns may also be expressed in terms of power per unit area, which is also known as Poynting vector, and it is denoted by S of theta phi at a certain distance from antenna. So similarly, if you write the normalized power pattern, this can be written as S of theta phi divided by S of theta phi max. And as it is both the fields, so the unit of this will be dimensionless. Also the Poynting vector S theta phi, if you are writing it in terms of field, it can be written as, so you have two components, theta component, phi component. So E square theta phi plus E square theta phi divided by intrinsic impedance Z naught, unit will be watt per meter square. And if it has to be converted to decibels, as it is power, the general formula is 10 log of Pn theta phi. So basically when you are considering the antenna in spherical coordinate system, you have two principal planes, that is one is theta plane and the other is phi plane. So theta plane, when you consider, theta will vary from 0 to pi and phi will vary from 0 to 2 pi. So general, if it's not specified how much is the angle, generally it has to be considered as for theta it should be considered as 0 to pi, and for phi it should be considered as 0 to 2 pi. So do share, like and subscribe to the channel for latest updates.